Another common symptom I hear from clients is issues with constipation. Now, constipation could be you don't go every day at the same time. It could be you don't go for 2 or 3 days at a time. But for many people, constipation really means several days at a time. And that constipation can get to the point that it's almost like a secondary symptom of how sluggish their gut feels, and that there can be other symptoms of abdominal pain and indirectly bloating. So the constipation can be worse than just don't go to the toilet every day. But when you're dealing with someone who's erratic with how often they're going, and then they're getting to the point where they actually can't perform a bowel movement when they do go, then that's more of a classic proper constipation that needs to be looked at on a more functional level. So that if you're not eating enough fibre, you're not drinking enough water, and you're not exercising, you won't be regular. If you've got an awful lot of stress in the morning, and in the mornings when you're trying to get out to work or dealing with kids or whatever, and you're trying to get out the door, and you do actually feel the need to go to the toilet, but you don't, and you're dead stressed, you're upsetting your kind of natural rhythm down there. And if you had a less stressful morning, we're consuming more water and high levels of fibre in your diet, maybe you actually would go to the toilet, have a bowel movement as you would like to. I deal with many clients that, even given the right environment to do that, they've got other issues that create constipation as a thing, right? It defines, it's the primary complaint, it's the thing that alters how they eat, what supplements they choose, how they exercise, whether they exercise or not, their energy levels, their sleep, and their overall mood. So constipation is like a proper serious thing. So for some people that might require, as well as trying to be less stressed, drinking more water, adding more fibre, creating a regular time to go to the toilet, is they could be looking to add more magnesium to their diet, which is a very common one. But I deal with clients that they add more magnesium either by eating more veg or actually adding it in the form of a magnesium supplement, and it doesn't touch the size, it really doesn't get you to shift. So there's not enough of a reduction in that symptom. So you need to look at the foods that could be shutting down your gut. So you want to identify what are the right foods for your metabolism that improve your energy. So if you've got constipation, you might see that as a lower energy situation. So lower energy, you don't have the oomph to go. So you want foods that stimulate your metabolism. And if you don't know what the right foods are, then you may not have the energy to not just not go to the toilet, you may just have low energy in general. So the stress and the exercising more and the water and the fibre, even adding magnesium, is just not enough. So one of the tests I look at is metabolic typing, that indicates that you actually need more veg of this type or more meats of that type to give you more than just magnesium, the right nutrients to raise your energy, and that can then lead to the stimulation of your digestive system to repair itself, to start slowly but surely removing constipation as a symptom. You might want more help in terms of finding out what's going on there in your gut to the whole start of the constipation by running a stool test, because possibly there are bugs in there. And in gross terms, those bugs feed on your food. And if they're feeding on your food in your gut, then they are also getting shot of their food inside you. And that can lead to overload in your gut, which slows down your ability to basically get the poo or to get that bowel movement going. So that's an overloading in your gut. Maybe what you also find is that when you've got constipation and you're obviously not going often to get rid of the toxins in your gut, and you're drinking more water, is how much you also urinate, how much you also go to the toilet, how much do you sweat, how much breathing are you doing? And exercise alone is only one part of the day. So maybe you need a period of 10 to 15 minutes at least every day where you concentrate on abdominal breathing, where you breathe in through your nose and your stomach goes out, and you breathe out through your mouth and your stomach goes in. So that's a more relaxed form of breathing that stimulates what's called your parasympathetic nervous system. This is a relaxation, digestion, repair part of your nervous system, not the stressed out fight or flight side. So if you spend at least 3 to 5 minutes, ideally maybe it's 10 to 15 minutes, that type of breathing, you can help support your digestive system that specifically helps the muscles of your digestion work. So that could be an extra tool on top of the more water, the more fibre, exercise, less stress. I guess also add magnesium. But the reason you need to add that the breathing part is because of the bugs in your gut that are causing the overload. You may also want to look at how healthy your liver is. So dandelion root tea is something that can help support your liver. Possibly having less coffee, so it creates more of a sympathetic or a stress response, takes some of the pressure off your liver, and it can do its job of packing up the rubbish or the toxins and helping getting them out. You can go to see people who specialise in visceral manipulation that helps reduce the tension in the nerves and the muscles within your gut, and that can help get things trucking along again. But if you're doing a stool test, or you're on a test called metabolic typing to find out the right foods to eat and also finding out what bugs are in there, maybe you also need to look at the support to improve the efficiency of how your gut works and the repair that go beyond magnesium, so that's probiotics. So, but if you knew from running a stool test the right bugs to swallow, or you can get food sources like kimchi, kombucha, sauerkraut, kefir, they're all forms of food basically that come in with more good bugs, right? But what you might want on top of that would be digestive enzymes that help break your food down. If you've got more support in your gut to break the food down, not only do you absorb more of your food, there's less load on your stomach muscles having to work, because if you're constipated, they're kind of detrained, they're not fit. So that will not help you create a bowel movement or get them out. So you can improve the fitness of your digestive system and therefore your muscles of your gut by adding digestive enzymes to help, or even adding pineapple as a food answer to improve your digestion, to help tackle constipation along with probiotics. And some people, things like a weak acid like apple cider vinegar, maybe a tablespoon in a large glass of water drank before a meal, maybe once a day, maybe several times a day, can also help you break down your proteins. Because you get protein, you get fat, and your carbohydrates all in your food. Whether you're more plant-based or whether you're more animal-based, you still need protein, fat, and carbs digested, and it's your probiotics, it's enzymes, and also, strictly speaking, within your stomach, hydrochloric acid, which you can supplement with. But apple cider vinegar could be a diet or almost a food or a drinking answer to help support further support your digestion. So you've got more kind of tips and tricks coming beyond the more water, the more fibre, and being less stressed and more exercise. So going through different tests builds up the layers of information that can help tackle constipation, which is a real blight, it's a real challenge for some people that can go on for months and in many cases years